Welcome to the Bedtime Stories. My name is Antonio Herrera. I am at Colgate University. I am the faculty co-director of the Hancock Commons, and I'm going to read today a short story by an Argentinian writer, Jorge Luis Borges. This is The Two Kings and the Two Labyrinths. It's a collection of book, a collection of short stories. The book se llama The Aleph. I'm going to read in English and then I'm going to read in Spanish. It's a very short story. We're in the middle of a pandemic and we are still trying to figure out a way out of this very difficult situation and painful situation for millions of us in the pandemic. These are the series were established in the context of the difficulty of us getting together. So we're inviting people to read favorite stories, sections of books. So here it goes. The Two Kings and the Two Labyrinths by Jorge Luis Borges. It is said by men worthy of belief, though, alas, knowledge is greater, that in the first days there was a king of the Isles of Babylonia who called together his architects and his priests and bade them build him a labyrinth so confused and so subtle that the most prudent men would not venture to enter it. And those who did would lose their way. Also, seemingly, was the edifice that resulted, for it is the prerogative of God, not man, to strike confusion and inspire wonder. In time, there came to the court a king of Arabs, and the king of Babylonia, to mock the simplicity of his guest, bade him enter the labyrinth, where the king of Arabs wandered, humiliated, and confused. Until the coming of the evening, when he implored God's aid and found the door. His lips offered no complaint, though he said to the king of Babylonia that in his land he had another labyrinth, and Allah willing, he would see that someday the king of Babylonia made its acquaintance. Then he returned to Arabia with his captains and his wardens. And he wreaked such havoc upon the kingdoms of Babylonia, and with such great blessing by fortune, that he brought low his castles, crushed his people, and took the king of Babylonia himself captive. He tied him atop a swift-footed camel and led him into the desert. 3 days they rode, and then he said to him, O king of time and substance and cipher of the century, in Babylonia, did you attempt to make me lose my way in a labyrinth of brass with many stairways, doors, and walls? Now the powerful one has seen fit to allow me to show thee mine, which has no stairways to climb, nor walls to impede thy passage. Then he untied the bonds of the king of Babylonia and abandoned him in the middle of the desert, where he died of hunger and thirst. Glory to him who does not die. Los dos reyes y los dos laberintos. Cuentan los hombres dignos de fe, pero Alá sabe más, que en los primeros días hubo un rey de las islas de Babilonia que congregó a sus arquitectos y magos y les mandó construir un laberinto tan perplejo y sutil que los varones más prudentes no se aventuraran a entrar. Y los que entraban se perdían. Esa obra era un escándalo, porque la confusión y la maravilla son operaciones propias de Dios y no de los hombres. Con el andar del tiempo vino a su corte un rey de los árabes, y el rey de Babilonia, para hacer burla de la simplicidad de su huésped, lo hizo penetrar en el laberinto, donde vagó afrentado y confundido hasta la declinación de la tarde. Entonces imploró socorro divino y dio con la puerta. Sus labios no profirieron queja ninguna, pero le dijo al rey de Babilonia que él en Arabia tenía otro laberinto y que si Dios era servido, se lo daría a conocer algún día. Luego regresó a Arabia, junto a sus capitanes y sus alcaldes, y estragó los reinos de Babilonia. Con tan venturosa fortuna que derribó sus castillos, rompió su gente e hizo cautivo al mismo rey. Lo amarró encima de un camello veloz y lo llevó al desierto. Cabalgaron 3 días y le dijo: «Oh rey del tiempo y substancia y cifra del siglo, en Babilonia me quisiste perder en un laberinto de bronce, con muchas escaleras, puertas y muros. Ahora el poderoso ha tenido bien que te muestre el mío, donde no hay escaleras que subir, ni puertas que forzar, ni fatigosas galerías que recorrer, ni muros que te veden el paso». Luego le desató las ligaduras y lo abandonó en mitad del desierto, donde murió de hambre y de sed. La gloria sea con aquel que no muere. Okay. Thank you. Gracias a todos.